This is the story of how one small island conquered the world.
Jamaican patois has been intruded in England.
And a fair start. Asafa Powell. Usain Bolt is also out well. Here they come down the track. Usain Bolt sprinting ahead. Winning by daylight.
It's a story of music, sport, and style.
Pull up, pull up.
How its rhythms, athletes, and language went global.
Jamaica is the new sprinting capital of the world. The Jamaican women swept the 100-meter final.
This is how Jamaica conquered the world. The 70s saw the rise of far-right racist parties like the National Front. But it also saw the start of a new, multicultural Britain that came alive on its streets.
My name's Johnny Behetz, and I'm 49.
Get up in the morning, slaving for bread, sir, so that every mouth can be fed. Oh, me Israelites.
Growing up in the 70s, where I lived, there was mainly white people, to be honest with you. It was mainly white, but there were more and more black and Asian people moving in, which for certain people was a problem.
In this country, in 15 or 20 years' time, the black man will have the whip hand over the white man.
And I can remember when I was very small, a chap knocking at the door. And I answered the door and he said, is your father there? And I said, yeah, my father's there. And he said, can you go get him? And my father came to the door. And he said, "Oh, sir, I've got a petition here because there's another black family moving into the area, and we've frankly had enough of this sort of thing." And my father, he didn't get angry or aggressive or anything. He just slowly clicked the door shut and then went back into the front room. And I always remember walking in there, and he sat there, he was reading his paper, and he looked over and he said, "You know, son, after the war, this country was a mess, a complete mess. We asked West Indians and Asians to come over here and help us rebuild the country." And he sort of pointed at me and said, "And that makes them as much part of this country as you are." And I'm sort of sitting there, you know, got to do it. But it was a message that was very, very clear to me. And he would also make a joke about it and say, "You know, what's the black people? What's the problem? You know, they love cricket," and he was a big cricket fan, and he was a big jazz fan. And so, although he didn't drill it into me, you know, it was a very, very strong message.
No matter what the people say, these sounds lead the way. It's the order of the day from your boss DJ, I King State. Hopped it from the top to the very last drop.
Shared a bedroom with my brother, and he'd be playing music all the time, and it'd be all the sort of the American funk, James Brown, and maybe a bit of soul, the Marvin Gaye and some P-Funk and that kind of stuff. But always going along in the background, always, never the mainstream, but always sort of pulsing along was the Trojan reggae sound that was absolutely everywhere. Like I say, it was never at the top, it was never the mainstream, but it was just always there. I had a few black friends, you know, there's a little mob of us who used to go around as I slowly grew up, and there's a mob of kids, and I always felt that they there was something about them, there was the way they wore their clothes, the way they walked, and above all, the music. And it was such a heavy influence on all of us, you know. The reggae thing, the soul thing, the funk thing. But it was definitely, as I say, this Jamaican rhythm going through the whole, you know, it's like a soundtrack in the background soundtrack of this amazing rhythm. And you could see a lot of the white kids were taking this on, and they were the skinheads, the original skinheads, who were not racist. They were the ones that were into the reggae. Which I never understand why they became this sort of symbol of race hatred. Well, I can remember when I was a little bit old, when it's probably about 76 or something, I can remember going around a friend's house and hearing the Pistols, the Sex Pistols, for the first time. And it was that first bit of Pretty Vacant, that dum 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 dum. And I remember everyone kind of sat back and went, wow. And then everything changed. You know, it wasn't just music, it was clothes, magazines, photography, art, everything just suddenly changed. It was funny in those, because things were very tribal. You were either a punk or you were either into the soul thing, or, and you weren't allowed to mix it, which I could never understand, because I loved the reggae and I loved the, and we all did really. But it's like, if you were a punk, you weren't allowed to admit that. And but then the Clash came along, and you could hear their music was heavily influenced by Jamaican sound, and the bass player Paul Simonon would play what were obviously reggae bass line, you know, particularly in things like Guns of Brixton and stuff like that. And I love that, you know, you could hear that influence coming in. And then later on, of course, the punk thing mixed even more with the ska sound, and you had the Specials and Madness and all these things. And it was just a brilliant, it was both cultures coming together, which is a wonderful, it was a really nice feeling, you know, it was unique British stroke Jamaican sound, and the influence that island's had on this country is immense for such a small place. Fashion and culture, in that sense, the Jamaicans, the influence was just absolutely incredible, and still is. You know, still, there's always that basic reggae sound, and terminology is still trudging along in the background, you know, of whatever's going on. Yeah, as far as being a white guy mixing with black people in that time, there was a sort of violent undertone going on in that era, because of course you had the Brixton riots and all that stuff going on. But there definitely was a movement of people who just wanted to say, look, you know, we're all in this together. It's not an issue. I think my life and my contemporaries would be completely different without the influence of Jamaica. Wouldn't be much fun, certainly.